grace, if you just heard that from Bridget, what a wonderful day this is. For the first time in your life, you're going to receive our report. This makes him very happy, and I can tell underneath your mask that you're very happy too. He's coming to dwell with you now for the very first time inside you. And it's not going to be your last time, but it's your first time. I'll see you again. We'll see you again once this pandemic ends off. We'll be able to see each other again at some point again. Continue to receive our Lord all the way through your entire life. What a wonderful day for yourself, for your grace. Also grace for mom and dad, grandma, grandpa, guardians, extended family. Our Lord is going to blanket your entire family with his grace and his charity this particular day. We begin, brothers and sisters, with the sign of our faith. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. be transformed by the renewing of your minds, so that you may discern what it is the will of God, what is good and acceptable and perfect. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. We stand for the gospel of the Lord. Been with you in this, and very being and intersect right in here, which made you who you are, right on the inside of your soul. Making your first communion now shows that you want to be closer to Jesus every day. You want to grow in His friendship and to lead others to Him also. Because of the joy that you're going to feel here, you're going to now take outside these four walls where you need. Jesus wants you, He needs you to work the miracle of the joy that you will have here today. Bring it to the world outside, to your school, to your house, to anywhere that you end up when you grow up. I'm happy, and we are happy here at John and Divine to share this great moment with you and to help guide you and lead you towards our Lord to meet Him today. You share this with the entire church, Holy Communion. This makes us brothers and sisters from this point onward, right after today. Father, you call me Father God, I'm also your brother. Everyone beside you is your brother and your sister from now. Spiritually, that's what you are going to become. From this point, when you receive God from this point now, God the Father is your Father. Jesus Christ, the second person of the Holy Trinity, from this point forward, is your God. He's also your brother. Not to be He's also going to be your brother. You're going to sit there, follow in the love of Jesus Christ, and the love that you have for each other. Love that you have for God always comes first in your life, and then your love for everybody else proceeds from that, comes forth from that. You want to share because God comes to dwell inside your heart. Remember, boys and girls, pray. Have that same joy and enthusiasm that you have today, always, always when you leave here. It'd be difficult at times, but that's okay. I have no doubt. Be in my prayers always. You'll be able to carry forth from here. I said before, this is your first communion, but not your last. Jesus will always be there. He'll be always with you, all through your entire life. Now, profess our faith for the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Our children come here today being prepared for this joyous day. The sacrament of heaven reconciled to our Holy Father. Now we pray with them too, our Father, as they prepare to receive Jesus, his Son. For our Pope Francis and Bishop Ronald Peter, for priests, deacons, and all members of God's family, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For all the children of the world, loved by the Lord Jesus Christ, especially those here today, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For these boys and girls who are going to receive Jesus Christ in the Eucharist, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For their family, friends, who share this holy celebration, this joyous day, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For all our relatives and friends who could not join us here today, pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Kind and gentle Father, receive our prayers as you welcome our children to your altar. Will they receive the body of your dear Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God, of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Through the earth and work of human hands, become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. Blessed be Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Through the vine and work of human hands, we become our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. The Holy Spirit come to you. Please stand. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. May this sacred offering, O Lord, confer on us always the blessing of salvation, and when it celebrates a mystery, it may accomplish in power Christ our Lord. And the Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty Eternal God. For when your children were scattered afar by sin, through the blood of your Son and the power of the Spirit, you gathered them again to yourself, that a people formed as one by the unity of the Trinity, made the body of Christ and the temple of the Holy Spirit, might to the praise of your manifold wisdom be manifest as the church. And so, accompanied with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed are you who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please be. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Thank you. our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in your hearts with your will, that the reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. With your spirit. Brothers and sisters, for the peace reading, if you're not from the same family, you didn't meet over in the same house together, just ask that you turn to one another and nod your head. Thanks to God. Congratulations, guys. Wonderful day. Thank you.
friends on either side of the way.
Peace.